which I think the caller he was talking to really took it in stride. There's not really controversy here, just like the way he talks about people makes people uncomfortable, but I like it. So that's the problem. I don't mind it, right? So if people don't mind it, should we mind the people who mind? But Ethan talked to someone he trusted, and so he went to them and said, hey, these people are mad at me. What should I do? And they're like, you should apologize, because Ethan doesn't want to hurt people's feelings. I do. And Ethan only wants to hurt Keem's feelings and Tim Pool's feelings. So keep in mind, Ethan will bully and attack anyone he doesn't like. He will justify it. He will take apart their life. He will Google them. He will snitch on them. Ethan is not afraid to fucking go after people. I disagree with who Ethan goes after and how he does it. In the same way, I disagree with Keem, but everyone is operating on their version of what's appropriate, right? So Ethan hurt his community. His community reached out and said, you know, I don't love this. And it's ironic because we all know Ethan got started hating SJW. So the fact that he's now appealing to like the left, and sort of the woke mob is fine. I don't have a problem with it because I do think his values have changed. I think his values have changed. So everyone's asking, what did Ethan do? Literally, from my understanding, I could be wrong, but I think they're talking about the controversy where he had a gay guest on and he was talking to them over the phone and he asked them about like having sex and being a bottom. I could be wrong, but I think that's what it's about. Now, it's the context isn't so important. I think the way they talk about each other is. Listen to the way Tim talks about Ethan and Ethan talks about Tim. They're not understanding that like you guys are all operating within a bubble of your own rules. And I've worked with Tim. I don't know Tim personally. We worked at the same event together. And I've seen Tim at events. He seems to be the same person he is on camera at events. So Tim seems consistent, but so does Ethan. To me, Ethan seems very consistent. He learns new information. He changes. Ethan is open and he wants to be compassionate and he wants to be helpful. So I think like when I look at them and I judge them, I try to just judge them on their own values. Ethan's working within his and Tim's working within his, right? So again, oh, AC says he was saying bottoms are more effeminate. Oh my God, is that not the truest fucking shit though?
That is correct, shorty.
I'm sorry, sir, when I'm in bottom mode, I'm absolutely more effeminate. Whether I'm a boy or a girl, a lot of the bottoms I know, that's accurate. That's what I'm saying. Ethan stereotypes because Ethan doesn't know real communities. Ethan only has one or two friends, but unless you've been in gay communities, and gay communities always talk about this shit, but when straight people talk about it, it sounds silly. It's kind of like when you see ethnic groups, like the way people joke and stereotype like Middle Eastern people is sort of true though, because when you're in Middle Eastern homes, we aren't literally stereotypes, but we are kind of stereotypes, you know? Ethan is joking about tops and bottoms tropes at the expense of James Charles. Not at all gay. Oh, no, that was different. So that was another controversy. So another controversy was that James Charles was buying diapers, I guess. And so Ethan was like, oh, he's a bottom bitch and like saying stuff. I don't know if he said bottom bitch. That's Brittany's language. But he said like he was making fun of like James Charles. But I think he feels so Ethan feels justified bullying anyone he thinks is unethical, which is very too, right? Isn't that everybody? Tim also feels very justified. Andy, no, all these people, and I've interacted with Andy, I've interacted with Tim, I've interacted with these people very briefly, but enough to be like, okay, even those people who met me at MythCon, they didn't know how to treat me. They're like, so what's Brittany? Is she like a sex worker? Is she like this? They need to know my tropes so they know how to treat me. So people who say they want to treat you as an individual, no, they don't. They want to put you in a box and they want to know how to treat you. Look at DGG or Mr. Girl's audience. Since I am every, and Destiny already called it out. Destiny is smarter because he's the one who pointed it out. Every one of my stereotypes puts me in a multitude of categories. Even my own brothers or like farm brother will say, you almost look normal, Brittany, but you're obviously not. Like you're so different, but like you can't fit in any group.
I'm weird. I'm a weirdo. I don't fit in.
No feminist will date me. No anti-feminist will date me. No religious person will date me. No atheist will date me because I don't want to fucking fight the rest of my life in your bubbles, right? So Ethan is one of those people that I see as very genuine because even though he is a, Ethan doesn't know his values, guys. Like Ethan's not that smart. He doesn't know what he's fighting for. So it's hard for me to judge him very strongly because he's not Tim Pool. Tim Pool should know better because he lives in politics every day, but Ethan just kind of comments and makes fart jokes, which we love. Which we love. You know what I mean? Heather says, I'm DGG and I've been capping hard for you, not gonna lie. Why did Ethan go after that? Oh, what? Who did Ethan go after that you disagree with? Nothing. Like, nothing. Like, that's the point. Is I'm trying to humanize both Tim Pool and Ethan in this conversation. I want to humanize people because that's my work. Like, my work is obviously humanizing people. But if you're going to discuss with me as an equal thinker, then I'm going to punch down on, or like, I'm going to punch at you, right? So when I'm talking about Ethan, I'm seeing Ethan as like a good father, a consistent husband, someone who loves Ela, a good businessman. He's good to his crew. He pays them fairly. He's so considerate of their feelings. And when they're sick, he helps out. Like, that's what I'm seeing. Ethan might be an idiot, but he's so fucking nice to the people around him. I just don't think people understand. Like, Ethan is genuine. He is not a grifter, right? Okay, so let's keep going.
Sounds like bullshit to me.